Hi, welcome to Robojax. In this video, I'm going to show you how we can use this infrared emitter and receiver as an obstacle avoidance. This can be used for educational purpose to learn the meaning of obstacle avoidance with Arduino. So this is the module, easy to use and very cheap. To explain the module, has three pins. This is VCC, this is ground, and that's the output. And we also have two LEDs here. This LED is for power. When you connect it to the power, it will be always on. And this LED is when it detects an obstacle. We have also a potentiometer that you can rotate and change the distance of the detection distance. For example, if you rotate it in one direction, it will detect it for a very short distance. But if you rotate it to the other direction, it will go to the maximum of 95 or 100 millimeter, which is 9.5 meter. This cannot detect an object longer than that for the further distance. So this is the emitter, which emits infrared ray. And when it hits the object, it just comes back. And this is the infrared receiver, which receives it. And there is a simple operational amplifier or op amp that can just detect the infrared and turn this light on. But the output will be low when it detects an object. So when there is nothing here, no obstacle, so this sends the signal and no infrared comes because there is no reflection, the output will be high. But when there is an obstacle in front of it, here, then it goes and comes back, and it will, if detects it, then this LED will be on, but this output will be low. So we are detecting low as an obstacle and high as clear or no obstacle. This sensor has two LED. One LED is for the power, and there is another LED which when it detects an obstacle, this LED will turn on. So now let me show you. I'm putting this, let's say this notebook, and the light is on because it has detected something. So how it works is that the infrared signal goes and reflects and backs, and this measures it. So with this potentiometer, we are actually changing the sensitivity of this one. So how strong signal it needs. The further the object, the weaker the signal that receives. So we can adjust it that it need, for example, if you want to decrease the distance, you are decreasing the sensitivity and it needs stronger signal. For example, at this distance, it works very well. So now let me increase the distance. As you can see, still it works. The light is on, which means there is an obstacle. I'm going further and now this is off. So if I put my ruler here, this is from here to here is 95 millimeter, so it's about 9 millimeter or 10 centimeter or 100 millimeter, as we call it. If you want to know it in terms of inch, it's about 3.5 inch, just 3¾ of an inch, so almost 4 inch. So if I get further, it turns off. Now at this stage, for example, now this is able to detect this object, but if you want to reduce it and make this not to measure this distance or any further, so we just rotate this and counterclockwise. I'm just rotating it the other way. So now as soon as I get away a little, the light is off, and now as you can see, it's almost 2 inch or 3 inch, about 7.5 centimeter. I just reduced the distance, so we can reduce it significantly, and then I'm just rotating it to the right, to the left further. So now this needs more closer. If you want to reduce the distance further, you can do so. So we can reduce it, but the maximum that this one can measure is 10 centimeters. This is about the distance that this can do. So slowly turn it clockwise, turn it to the right until the light is on. So now the light is on, it doesn't detect, and here it detects. So this way you can reduce and increase the distance with this potentiometer. So the when it detects an obstacle, this LED is on, but the output actually goes off. So when there is nothing, the output is high, or there is a 5 volts at the output. This last pin. So this pin will always have 5 volts when there is no obstacle. When there is an obstacle, now this is on, the output is 0. Now let me explain the code. This line inside the setup is for displaying on the serial monitor, 9600 baud, and then we set pin 8 as an input. And then inside the loop, which is the main one, we read the pin 8. We say digital read 8, so that is the status of pin 8, and the result is stored in the variable integer detect. And here we say if detect is equal means compare it. Compare this to this. If it's low, then the obstacle is detected, so we say obstacle on the way. Else, otherwise, we say all clear. And then we wait 300 milliseconds, so this is almost 3 times a second. So it just continues like that. So let me load the code and then open the serial monitor here. You can see on the screen it shows all clear and there is no obstacle on the way. So if I measure this, so this is about 10 centimeters. So let me bring an object. You see, when it detects an object, it says obstacle is on the way. This text, when it turns off, so obstacle on the way. This way you can detect it. Now, what you can do is, if when the obstacle is detected, you can also control a servo. So when you say if detect is equal low, which means obstacle detected, so here you can just give a command to a servo to do something. And if a motor is stopped, if a motor is running, you can stop it, or you can turn on something else. So whatever you want to do, it will be between this F. Or if there is no obstacle, you can do something here. So the action will be here. So I will create another video to show how this one can control a servo to rotate it at certain angle, and that can be connected to a steering wheel so it can go left or right. Until as I was looking to find out the diagram for this module, I came across so many diagrams. For example, this one, this is completely wrong. For example, this one, the output of this op amp is high. If this is high, then the LED will be on, the obstacle detected, that's correct. But this one is high, which contrary to the module. The module is always low when this is high. So this was one diagram, and there is another diagram circulating. Somebody shows this one. This is also incorrect. So the code for this project will be available by clicking at the link in the description below. And also you can go directly to robojax.com/learn/arduino. Thank you for watching. Please thumb up the video, please share it, and also subscribe so you can get updates of my upcoming videos.